What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCP Euro DIY. Today, we're going to be working on a 2008 Volkswagen Mk5 GTI. Today on the Mk5 behind me, we're going to be covering how to replace your ignition coils and spark plugs. In front of us, we have a Bremi NGK kit, which is available on fcpo.com. Typically, a good practice to follow is 100,000 miles for the ignition coils, and spark plugs should be replaced every 60,000 miles. Now, the car behind us has 245,000 miles. We're not quite sure of its service history, so it's certainly due for a replacement. Typically, bad spark plugs can cause a misfire, poor fuel economy per performance. Same thing with an ignition coil. If you have a misfire, and you're trying to track it down, maybe you have ignition or cylinder one misfire, swap the coils first, see if the code follows. If the code does not follow, then more than likely your plug is bad. And if that doesn't fix your problem, then you may have to diagnose further. But typically it's just a plug and or a coil. If you can, we recommend you replace them both, especially if you're not sure on what the service history of your vehicle is. But before we get started on this DIY, let's take a look at some of the tools we're gonna need for this job. For this job, the most important tool you're gonna need is a 5/8 drive spark plug socket. Along with that, we have a ratchet. We have a 3/8 drive ratchet and 3/8 drive torque wrench. Small flathead screwdriver or pick will also help. And depending on how fancy you want to get with this, there are some special tools designed for pulling out the ignition coils. You can also use a zip-tied loop around the body to pull them up. Today, we'll just be using our hands and maybe a little bit of flathead screwdriver help, but nothing too crazy. Now with that, let's go ahead and get started on this DIY. All right, my good people, we're under the hood of the GTI here. Now, it goes without saying that you want to do this on a nice, cool car. This car has been sitting here overnight, so it's nice and cool to the touch, makes working on it a lot easier, and you don't really want to pull plugs when the engine's hot. So first step here is going to be to get the coils popped up a little bit so that we can disconnect the harness. Now this usually tends to be the trickiest part of the DIY. Should be able to show you a quick tip on how to get those off. Now, to be quite fair, I have yet to see a 2-liter turbo equipped with the hardware that holds down these harnesses ever. I believe they're T20s from the factory, so if your car still has that, go ahead and pull those off now. And if I missed a size, please drop me a comment below. Let us know what size those are. But moving forward, we're gonna go ahead and work on popping up the coils a hair. Now, because we are replacing these ignition coils, we're not gonna be super gentle with them, but we're not trying to be destructive either. We use a small flathead screwdriver to get them up. Another alternative, let's just say you're doing plugs today, is you can grab a zip tie, loop it around the back half of the coil and use that to pull it up. And if you want to get fancy with it, like I said, there is a special tool out there that you can key over the coil and lift up the body. Today, we're going to use the flathead method. We're just going to use the actual ignition coils to pry off of. So I'm going on cylinder 3 and just lifting up cylinder 4. Pretty easy. We just need about 1/4 to 1/2 inch to come up. This is going to give us room to get the harness out. This one we can just slowly work up, barely putting any pressure on the valve cover. We're not trying to put a hole in our valve cover. We're just trying to get this lifted up a little bit. All right, now that we have the ignition coils lifted, we can disconnect the harness. There's a tab on each one. These are the ones you're going to want to press down. It helps to push the connector in towards the coil first and then pull back. See if we can do this without the flathead. So you can hear it unlock. We're going to push in towards the coil and then pull back. That's one. This one came with it. There we go. That can just hang out to the back. And we can pull these out. Now we'll drop in our 5/8 socket. This one has a built-in extension. If you do not have one with a built-in extension, just get one, add it on, no problem. Using a 3/8 drive ratchet, we're just gonna back up the spark plug. Now we blew the top here with some compressed air, believe it or not. I know it doesn't look great. Just to make sure no debris fell down here. Usually if you're rocking the beauty cover, that helps keep a lot of the debris out. But in this case, this car has an aftermarket intake, no beauty cover. So it tends to collect a little bit of pollen and dirt. So we hit that with some air, blew everything off. Here's our old plug. A little white, but it's not wet, which is great. It smells pretty regular, so not too bad. This has been in here for about 40,000 miles. So a little preventative, if you will, on the 60,000 mile scale, but it's not gonna hurt anything today. So we're gonna set this to the side. We're gonna grab our new plug. This happens to be a magnetic socket, which helps, so it allows us to not drop it in the hole. If you don't have a magnetic socket, you can use something like a fuel line. We have a BMW spark plug tool, which we'll also link down below, which is essentially a thick rubber piece of hose that you key over the body of the plug, and it allows you to set them in nicely. Now, whenever you do spark plugs, it's a good rule of thumb to back up the socket a little bit, just in case the plug engaged into the threads of the cylinder head incorrectly. You don't want to risk stripping them. So just give it a couple turns in the reverse. Drive it in, if you can, all the way by hand, which is exactly what we just did now. Then we have our torque wrench set to 25 Newton meters. There we go. Not a whole lot. And then at this point, it's completely dealer's choice if you choose to run a little bit of dielectric grease on these or not. You can run a little bit on the outside of the rubber spacers here and just a hair on the tip. Personally, whenever you have a push coil on like this, if you do too much, it's gonna cause the coil to ride up. And considering we don't have any of the hardware holding down the harness here, we're not gonna go too crazy. So we've done just a small dab on the inside of the coil. We're gonna drop it in. We're not gonna press it down all the way just yet. We're gonna leave it up a little bit, just like we did when we removed them, to get the harness plugged back in. So with that, we're gonna go ahead and just zap through the other three, and we'll pick it back up in a second. All right, now that we have all of the plugs in and the ignition coils are just a tad bit in, we're gonna get our harness plugged back in. Wanna make sure we hear for a nice click on all four of them, line them up properly. If you need to, you can key them a little bit in whatever direction you may need and pull towards us. All right, now we can push them all the way down. There you go, you wanna hear a nice solid engagement from all of them. And at this point, if you have the hardware that holds down the harness, again, let me know in the comment section what size that should be. Go ahead and install those now. Throw your booty cover back on, and that's going to be a wrap for today's DIY, my good people. Overall, a really straightforward and easy job on the 2-liter turbo. Definitely a good beginner's DIY as well if you're just starting to get into your car and trying to figure out how to wrench on it, and just some good service practice. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave those in the comment section below. And if you want to see DIYs like this and more, please consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.